we are outside of the Dollar Tree. And what I bet you're wondering is you're wondering, Blake, it's 2020. Can I still make money buying Dollar Tree items, soaps, toothbrushes, books, whatever? Can I still make money and enough money to pay for my mortgage, pay for my car payment by buying these things here and flipping them online on Amazon, on eBay, on Mercari, on Etsy, wherever? The answer is yes, an emphatic yes. Yes, you can. And this video is gonna go over how to do that. I'm gonna show items in that store you can sell online to make a bunch of money. And at the end of the video, I'm gonna go through all the math, tell you all the fees, tell you everything you need to know to start doing this. Are you ready? If you are, let's get in there and make some money.
Rolling right into it, we're going to go with some American seed flowers. Now, there are also vegetables in this little display tower on the side end, like these chili peppers right here. I would say pick those out first. I've noticed that vegetables, things you can eat, sell better in small quantities because these large pretty flower packets, you can buy a pound of those for dirt cheap. But the vegetables you can eat, your audience is more people who are trying to have a garden in their kitchen or their bedroom or whatever, and they're the ones who are willing to pay a little bit more for a packet, or ideally, you bulk these up into a lot of 10 vegetables or whatever it is, and you sell those for $1 a piece. You're only paying a quarter a pack. You can see very quickly how that adds up to make some money. Now again, this is not a $10,000 a month job, but it is a segue into a new business for you. What do you do after you sell your first 100 bucks in seeds? Well, you buy more seeds, you get a wholesale account. I'm editing the video and I realized I want to say some more stuff. So all of these things, these are not end games for you, okay? You're not going to be the kind of person who pays the rest of their life away selling Dollar Tree stuff. But it is a stopgap, a good way to make some money in the short term. And in the long term, you're going to be learning skills. You're going to be learning what buyers want. And you can take that information, apply it to your own wholesale business, which is so easy. You just have to buy things from a manufacturer and sell them that way. And then you transition from this, part-time, I'm having fun buying seeds at Dollar Tree, to an actual real, sustainable, reliable business. That's how these things work. You have to start off small, and I want to help you do that. Everyone always wonders, why do you do these videos, Blake? You know, if it gets popular, I'm gonna get a bunch of shitty comments. They're gonna say, oh, he's a shill. A shill for who, the Dollar Tree? Like, what are you talking about? This is the way businesses start. They start from the ground up. It's not easy. It's not always the most lucrative thing to do, but as you learn and as you progress, then it becomes much more valuable. Okay, on to the next thing. The next one is going to be anything that is branded like this. These are all Nickelodeon branded vinyl figurine keychains. There's Toy Story 4, there's Disney, there's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Batman, DC Universe stuff. Really cool. And even though these sell for between 3 and 10 bucks individually, the real profit in these comes in bulking them together and making lots, making a Justice League lot, making a Toy Story 4 lot of 4 or 5 or 2 or 3 items, and then even though the revenue is the same per item, 5 bucks an item, 10 bucks an item, whatever it is, you are saving on shipping. You can do it for this kind of stuff too. Brain teasers, puzzles, all of this stuff has a per item shipping cost. And if you lot the items together, then that per item shipping cost is gonna go down. That's always good because the lower our expenses are, be it packaging materials, be it shipping, be it whatever, the lower those numbers are, and if revenue stays the same, the higher our net profit will be. And net profit is money in your pocket at the end of the day. You always want to maximize that. Now would be a good time to remind you, please subscribe and like the video. If you're new, I have several videos on Dollar Tree books. They are from a year or two ago though. So, do Dollar Tree books still sell in 2020? Absolutely they do. And I'll have a video coming on that pretty soon. But for the time being, what do you have to know about these books to sell them? Well, the first thing you gotta know is what are remainder marks. That little black dot right there, that's a remainder mark. It means that this book has been taken out of some giant retailer's inventory and through reverse logistics means got into this Dollar Tree. You can't sell books as new if they have a remainder mark on them, or at least if you do that, you may be opening yourself up to liability, et cetera, et cetera. Now here's a book Ford Nation that does not have any remainder marks and does not have a sticker on the bottom of it. Sometimes they put ATSD stickers over there, whatever. The barcode is unadulterated, and this book is in new condition. Now I'm going to show you how to look it up right now because it's very, very simple. So when you look up these books on Amazon, really all you're doing is just scanning the back of the book, scanning the barcode, and it'll pop up the listing. It's very, very simple. We can see the sales rank is super high, but it's selling for a decent amount of money. The new books sell for almost $19. Now, what I would do for this book specifically, I would not sell it on Amazon FBA. I would sell it merchant fulfilled, meaning I keep it in my warehouse. This is different than FBA because in FBA, they keep the book. Now, we're seeing that every book is worth selling. Some are kind of duds, but that first book I showed you, the Ford Nation book, that proved that, okay, maybe it might take 4 months to sell, but there definitely is profit on these shelves. Not a huge amount of profit, but if you can buy 10 copies of those books, or you can buy 10 different copies of 10 different books that all sell in 4 months for 10 bucks profit, and it takes you 2 minutes to buy them, why wouldn't you? Interlude number two, and oh my God, I have tried so many times to explain this concisely. Please bear with me here. So when I talk about how much money you make per hour in other videos, that really hangs a lot of people up. I say you can make 100 bucks an hour, and you easily can. Do you honestly think if you scan every single book in a Dollar Tree, you're not gonna find 100 bucks profit there? And do you honestly think that if you do that, you can't take that same list and go to the other Dollar Trees in your area and buy those same books and multiply your profits? And whoa, well, if I've already scanned the books the first time, my second time going to another Dollar Tree, I'm not gonna have to scan them again, meaning I'm saving so much time, meaning again, for that hour of work, you are bringing in how much money? $500? Yes, it takes a year to make maybe, but if you have a business, if you are thinking long term, why is that a big deal? But Blake, you idiot, I need money right now. How can I make money right now? Well, don't worry, folks. I have some quick flips for you right here. And these are the Mead security envelopes. You are paying about 2.5 cents per envelope at the Dollar Tree. And on eBay, these sell for about 10 cents per envelope. That is some beautiful retail arbitrage right there. It is not all the envelopes, only the Mead security envelopes. And these are pretty much an evergreen product. People always need them, and Dollar Trees almost always have them. You can buy them today, sell them tonight. Check on eBay, I promise you. There's also ramen noodles. Now, I hesitate to add these because it's coronavirus season. You know, people are acting kind of crazy. These are a food you might buy if you were quarantining yourself. And so maybe the price is a bit wonky right now. But all of these dollar homemade convenience meals, you can bundle them up, sell them for two or three times what you paid for, and make some money that way. I've seen these Idaho mashed potatoes sell for $7.50 a piece on Amazon, a piece. Now again, that was because the Amazon stock ran out, but still, the demand is there. There might be a surplus in supply, but the demand is there for people to pay $5 to $7 per item for stuff like this. Okay, but what about shipping, Blake? Surely shipping must bankrupt this business idea. No, it doesn't. So when you sell these things, generally we're looking at two ways you can ship them: first class mail or media mail. Don't ship the seeds only using a stamp, because you're gonna get someone saying, "I didn't get those," and they're gonna take your money away from you. So with first class mail, that means it's under 16 ounces, which is a pound, and that's gonna ship for between $2.76 is the cheapest end I've ever seen, and like $5.67 is the most expensive I've seen it, and this depends upon where you are located as well as where your customer is located. The other way you're gonna do this is by using media mail, and media mail is cheap. It's like $3 a book, a little more if they're heavier. Now, secondly, what are the fees for marketplaces? Generally, what I assume is a 15% fee. Now, that's going to include the PayPal fee and the eBay fee, or just the Amazon fee, because Amazon does their own payment processing. But generally, that's a good number to go off of. Is every marketplace 15%? No, it's just a good guideline to go off of. And if you're someone who's worried that fees are going to eat all your profit, why wouldn't you estimate high? Now, what about the cost of gas? I'm sure that there are so many people out there who are curious about the cost of gas, because oftentimes some idiot says, "You drove to that store, clearly you're making no money." That is the stupidest thing I have ever heard in my entire life. If you can't afford to drive to a dollar store to do some research, to go to five more dollar stores, you should be getting a job. Okay, so we talked about fees, we talked about shipping, we talked about the cost of gas. What else is there? I think that pretty much covers it. But if you have more questions, please leave a comment below with that question and I will do my best to answer it thoroughly and concisely. Again, I do these videos because I want to help people understand how to make money. I don't make them, these videos, to show people lists of things to buy. I make them because if you understand how supply and demand work, the world is your oyster. See you guys later, and don't be a shithead.